Hello and good morning, guys. And today we are going to discuss a latest news of the corporate world, which has shocked the entire corporate world. And it's rather a gloomy news and not a very cheerful news. And more than shock for me, it was saddening, because the man whom we are going to talk about right now was always my idol. I always used to look up to him for his talent, entrepreneurial skills, and the kind of courage which he had to start up a venture which is absolutely unlike the normal ventures which were there in market. Yes, I am talking about VG Siddhartha, who is late VG Siddhartha now. Just few hours back, he has been found dead in a river, and yes, he has committed a suicide. Before committing suicide, he has dropped a suicide note, and he's very well in a very sporty manner taken all the responsibilities of the losses which were there in Cafe Coffee Day, and the company which was owned by him, and he was the promoter of that company. In 1996, he had opened this company and created this entire empire of coffee in India, where the country was a tea loving country, and India has always been a tea loving country. In that tea loving country, he had the guts and the courage to introduce coffee and make it such a big deal. So yes, initial few years, almost a decade, went really profitable for Cafe Coffee Day. But the last few years, or almost a decade, saw terrible decline in Cafe Coffee Day's profits, and that was the reason why debt-laden Cafe Coffee Day could not survive for a very long time. And hence, VG Siddhartha decided to take this harsh step, which keeps haunting me, and this step has asked a question within me, that would entrepreneurship lead to such a harsh decision in your life? Would business losses be even more important than your life? Would a career be so important in your life, and be entangled in such a mess will be so important that a person can be forced to take his life? All these questions are haunting me as I read the news, and I see on news channels that his body has been recovered from a river. I don't know, I am a little disturbed, but yes, I want to read out some paragraphs from his side notes. Guys, the paragraph reads as under: I gave up as I could not take any more pressure from one of the private equity partners forcing me to buy back shares, a transaction I had partially completed 6 months ago by borrowing a large sum from a friend. Guys, the matter is very clear that the entire company was under losses, and Siddhartha had taken a lot of loan, and he could not repay the loan, and he had to succumb to the pressures of the private equity partners. And we have already discussed private equity partners, who are private equity partners, in our last video. He succumbed to the pressures which were created by the private equity partner. Not only private equity partner, one more person that he has named was pressurizing him was, yes, the Income Tax Department of India. So the letter refers to Income Tax Department as follows, and I quote: a lot of harassment from the previous DG. DG is a Director General of Income Tax, in the form of attaching our shares on two separate occasions to block our Mindtree deal and then taking possession of our Coffee Day shares. Although the revised returns have been filed by us, this was very unfair and has led to a serious liquidity crunch. So guys, the matter is pretty clear that he had no other way to revive the debt-laden company, which is Cafe Coffee Day, and he had to succumb to this entire pressurizing situation. Although the company was a 3,200 crore big company, but the debt was almost double of the size of the company, and the company was started by merely a few lakhs of rupees, and it grew at such a big magnitude. The mind behind this company was, yes, VG Siddhartha, and I respect him for his mind, I respect him for his courage, I respect him for his endurance. Seeing this end, I am saddened, definitely I am saddened, and I am forced to think, what were the problems with that company? And trust me, the problems which I am going to highlight is not only was the problem of Cafe Coffee Day, but problems of many other companies which have followed the same fate in past. And yes, you can think of a lot of frauds, a lot of companies which have shut down. And the three prime reasons behind the shutdown would be exactly the things which I am going to point out now. Guys, point number one, debt is a slow poison for most of the companies, and taking a lot of debt and may benefit the shareholders from a leverage standpoint, but it increases the risk to a very large extent. Soon as the risk increases, pressure on management to perform well increases. The moment that pressure increases, management might go ahead and take wrong decisions. And the moment the management take wrong decisions, that is the time which can lead to downfall of any company. So the very first point which I could find from all these failures is a debt-laden company. Debt works as a slow poison. It will eat you away from inside, and it will it might lead to harsh repercussions. Point number two would be, it is really important for a business to identify the key time to come out of that business, or key time to make a full stop from that business. So maybe a first decade of Cafe Coffee Day was very, very fruitful and very profitable. But soon as things changed, because there was a heavy cost of around 12,000 outlets. And 1200 outlets all across the country, there was a huge cost associated to those outlets. And soon as you realize that you are not able to recover that cost, then I think you should try and cut down or shorten your debts and your expenses so that you are able to at least survive in market. So it's really important for a businessman to understand that there's a right time to press the exit button. An exit button is to be pressed at the right time, and it's really important to press the exit button. Third and most important point is, guys, the environment is dynamic. The environment is ever changing, and in this competitive world, if you do not change, then you will probably remain obsolete. After advent of Starbucks, after advent of barista, after advent of each local shop serving cold coffees at a very concessional prices, there was a demand to change, there was a need to change, there was a need to transform the business. And I think if you do not transform your business as per the market needs, then you might have a survival risk. Although, having said these three points, as if I'm a big gyani of management, let me tell you one thing. It's very easy said than done, guys. It's very easy for me to come before all of you and give some management gyans, which might have worked for CCD. But only Siddhartha knew what went through CCD when he decided to take such a harsh step. So yes, he's gone now, a man who's instrumental in changing the way beverages were served in India. And at a very early year, 1996 is when he started off this particular venture, which really was successful. Now, he's no more. Now, let's see what will happen to the shares of CCD. They've already declined by 20%. And let's see what is the fate of this company, whether we'll have that those amazing cold coffees, which I at least used to love. Let's see if we still have continuity with respect to Cafe Coffee Day outlets. What will happen to future? I don't know. But yes, I am saddened by this news. So three important takeaways which I am going to give to my students with respect to their financial management, from which is absolutely arising from this particular instance and many other instances which have come up in past. Three important things which you should understand while managing your finance. Number one, there are no free lunches in this world, guys. Please understand this. So if someone is luring you to have purchased an investment which will yield you some 30%, 40% return, please do not fall for the trap, because there are no free lunches in this world. No one can earn more than what market is earning for you. If someone is earning for you more than what market is earning for you, then definitely that person is going to take his or her cut. So please learn to read the hidden asterisks behind every investment or every proposal which you are willing to do. There are no free lunches in this world. Takeaway number two, avoid using credits, guys. Credit cards, loans, EMI schemes, short-term loans, long-term loans, all these things are not going to be beneficial for all of you, especially as a student. So I already have 12 years of experience in working in corporate world, and I have corporate cards, credit cards, which I swipe only when I'm going on an official tour. I do not use those corporate cards for my personal purposes. I do not own a personal credit card till date. I do not. I don't believe in spending money which is obtained from credit. If I have the money, I'll purchase a thing. If I don't have the money, I would refrain from purchasing the thing. Guys, do not fall for this trap. It's just a trap. Once if you fall in this trap, then you are bound to get trapped or bound to get caught in this trap, and you might find it difficult to come out of this trap. So don't make it a habit to use credit. Takeaway number three, invest very, very carefully, guys. Unless and until you have full knowledge of the investment which you are doing, like your shares, like your debentures, like whatever you want to purchase, please invest very, very carefully. At least 60% of your savings should be in risk-free debts, risk-free investments, instruments. Yes, 40% is a big number still. Out of 40%, 20% or 10% should be in absolute risky investments like shares. And 20% should be in medium risk securities like mutual funds, etc. Guys, unless and until you have full knowledge of stock market, please do not, on the basis of hearsay, just invest your 20,000 bucks, 30,000 bucks in any and every company. Do not do that. I'll definitely keep on coming back with more such vlogs. And till that time, all the very best. Please be safe, be secured, and happy studying.